Sweetness of Iman. People tend to like sweets. Sweets make you happy. Happiness equals sweet. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, ثَلَاثُ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ حَلَاوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ, that three things, if you find it, you will find the sweetness of Iman. Number one, أَنْ يَكُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَاهُمَا, that you love Allah and His Messenger above every single thing. That's why even Umar radiallahu anhu was asked, do you love? He said, yes, yes. And I'm paraphrasing very quickly. And he said, do you love me over yourself? The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked. He thought, and then he said, yes. Then he said, al-ana, now you are actually the one who actually truly believes. So we are supposed to love Allah and His Messenger even above ourselves. Secondly, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wa an yuhibba al-mar'a la yuhibbuhu illa lillah, that you love a person only for the sake of God, only for the sake of Allah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, wa an yakraha an ya'uda fil kufri kama yakrahu an yuqdhafa fil nar, that brothers and sisters, your earning should be not above Allah and His Messenger. It should not be a lupine behavior. You should taste the sweetness of Iman by complying to what is moral. Your dress should not be above Allah and His Messenger. Vulgar, downright dirty. Even animals cover themselves. Sweetness will not enter if it is above that. Wealth should not be above Allah and His Messenger. How can so many people go hungry and have not, and you indulge in such porcine behavior? It just can't be that your wealth should not be above Allah and His Messenger. Your health should not be above Allah and His Messenger. Because if you smoke, you are disobeying Allah and His Messenger. If you drink, you're doing the same thing. If you do drugs, you're doing the same thing. You have to be very careful. You will not find the sweetness of Iman if you do these things, because Allah and His Messengers above all. Secondly, you love only for the sake of Allah. That's why it will make you sincere. Ikhlas is a big word in Islam. Sincerity is big, because ikhlas is something that detaches you from a trap. It makes you sincere only for His sake. Praying for someone you do not know shows your ikhlas, shows your sincerity. And thirdly, that you hate to return back to disbelief as you would be hate to turn back or thrown into the fire. Because every day of yours must be better than the day before. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated that no, the believer's 2 days should not be equal, meaning you should always be improving yourself. Your spiritual weights must increase on a daily basis. You can't lift weights 5 pounds for 3 years and expecting bulging muscles and great fitness. You increase the weight, you increase your intensity, because as you become better, you increase. Why is it that in spirituality we say the same old mundane kind of prayer, we do the same thing, we're done in 2 minutes and we're on to the next thing? There's no contemplation, there's no meditation, there's no spiritual weight behind that. Why is that? And then you know that the masjid and the Quran are not only for Ramadan, brothers and sisters, it is for every day. Try your best to do the right thing and try to get the sweetness of Iman, but you have to have these three qualities in order to have it. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to you. It is easy for you to get, it is harder to hold on to, because it takes practice. It's an everyday affair. May Allah bless you and give you this tawfiq, and may you have it for always. Ameen.